Hello my dear students, welcome all of you to your SST class. We are doing the chapter first, history, and that is where, when and how. In previous class we have discussed about the division period of Indian history and the impact of geography on Indian history. Today in this video we will discuss about the India new and old terminology and different sources about the medieval period. So let's start with the first topic, and that is new and old terminology. Across the ages, India has been referred to by different names. However, quite often the area of land suggested by each name has differed. The more famous among these names are Aryabhatta first. Okay, look at this. The land of Aryans, this name was given around 150 BCE to the northern part of India. Okay, Hindustan, this term is derived from the Greek word Indus or Indos. India got its name because of the people living around the Indus River. The in Persian and Arabic meaning Hind indicates the Indian subcontinent. According Minas Ussiraj, Hindustan means the area between Punjab and Haryana and the land between Ganga and Yamuna. Bharat means, already we get so many times in Sanskrit word, the Bharat meaning, Bharat name actually. Okay. Bharatvarsha, the country was so named after the Bharata tribe that existed in the Rig Vedic times. And last of all, India, this term was used by the British. Now, my dear children, we are going to talk about the sources of information about medieval time. We divide sources of information into two groups, literary sources and archaeological sources. Under the literary sources, again we divide it accounts of Indian writers, account of foreign writers, court chronicles and some biographies and autobiographies. So, look at your book, page number 13. So, first paragraph is all about the autobiography, like Babur's Babur Nama, Jahangir's Jahangir Nama. Second paragraph all about the King's Council, means court chronicles, okay, court writers, not chronicles. So, these are Faisal Akbar Nama, Aini Akbari, okay, Abul Faisal Akbar Nama and Aini Akbari. And the next one, the Barwani Tariki Firoz Sahi. Third paragraph is all about the chronicle. So, what is the meaning of chronicle? Chronicle means a fact-based written account of historical event. It is called chronicle. So, we are having there in Raj Sarangini by Kalhana, and the, all this type of chronicles is all about any kind of area or state. Just like the Raj Sarangini is all about the history of Kashmir. Chand Bardwai Pithiraj Raso is all about the rule of Prithviraj Chauhan. And third, fourth paragraph is all about the Indian writer, just like the Firdausi Sahanama, okay, or we can say the Inayat Khan Sahajan Nama, Minaz Us Siraj Tahkeet E Firoz Sahi. Okay, so, and fifth paragraph is all about the Indian writers or prominent Purans, Veds like Ramayana and Mahabharata. Okay. Foreign accounts are an invaluable sources of information about the medieval period, because the foreign travelers and scholars who visited India wrote candidly and honestly about what they saw and experienced in the India. So we can say ke jo Indian account hai, jo literary sources hai, usse bhi jyada prominent hai, bahut hi valuable hai foreign account. So we are having some data about the foreign accounts. So Alberoni's Tahiki Ind, Ibn Battuta Rihala, okay, and Niccolo Conti's Seth Thomas Rose, Domenico Pierce, Marco Polo, etc. So Niccolo Conti has given a detailed description of the Vijayanagara kingdom and the capital of city of Hampi. So okay, apart from this writing, also we have lot of writings by Bhakti and Shupi Sens and writing in regional languages like Bengali, Hindu, Gujarati, Marathi. So my dear children, that's enough for today's class. Before leaving the class, just check out this data about the literary sources about medieval time. So please write down this data in your copy. So that's the end. We will meet in our next class with new topics. Till then, bye, take care and happy learning.